see a lot of distance keeping from both players. At least the one good thing, I guess, that you know, that ZSS, I mean, it's one good thing, multiple good things, is that Zayr is definitely able to break sometimes. But on top of that, ZSS ult is really fast. But it doesn't matter if you're still gonna get hit by every option. The double spot dodge at this point. Yeah, once again, we're just gonna see Squid Plumber just keep his keep AOS at bay. AOS struggling to get in. The amount of projectiles Squid Plumber can throw, and he's stuck at ledge. Great conversion there. So, but yeah, once again, we're just going to see a lot of general projectiles being thrown out. A lot of long distance hitboxes. And we're probably going to see some ZSS struggling at first. I imagine, though, if AOS can zone break, it's going to destroy a lot of the momentum that Squid Plumber has. Great shield, though. And yeah, deciding to go to the ledge rather than try to force themselves at... try to go back in. Oh, the whip, not... And slow down air. Not exactly great for...
That tipper forward tilt is deceptively strong, especially when you hit the tipper hit. It just kills a percent that you would not expect.
Yeah. And it... Okay. CSS, the bounce off.
Oh,
it was the nerf, guys. That was a hitbox, and he's at 84. He's not dead yet, but here's the thing. Squid Plumber is at 116. He's dead. Yeah. Okay. I was gonna say they're both at high percent, and Victor with rage honestly is a lot better than ZSS with rage,
for sure.
But here's the thing that.
Just the pure damage output out from Richter. He already deals a lot of damage, then you stack rage on top of it, and just racks up insanely quickly.
Yeah, and but here's the thing, is that AOS can quickly switch the game. We know AOS to be an explosive player sometimes, and ZSS just blows people, can just blow people up at times. He just has to get it, and that's not how. Can't commit to a hard option, because as funny as people will like to make memes, the whip is a lot better offline. I'm just going to say it. You can actually react to stuff with it, such as, you know, that overcommitment with the flip kick. I think we may have had the JTS people in here. It's a loud bunch, but emotional players, and we love to see it in Smash Bros.
Indeed.
Oh, that was not a great air dodge. Got stuck in a rock in a hard place, and had to choose the bad option either way.
Yeah, Squid's starting to catch onto these boost kicks.
That was a good wait by Squid.
Great tech.
Probably could have fared, honestly, but that's now he's back off stage. Wait uses the flip kick. He's gonna take it. I don't know. I can't say I'm gonna see a stage where ZSS can go that just changes the pace totally, because I can see an FD switch if needed.
Yeah,
but then you lose a lot of the platform extensions.
Exactly.
But you do get better approach options at times due to the fact that even if it's just straight up, they don't have a platform to mess around with, so you can definitely get in there. See town just from the fact that the platforms once again do give you more space to play around with rather than the limiting options of PS2. So it goes back and forth.
The platforms really are a double-edged sword, because CSS gets a lot of extensions off of it, but then it allows Squid Plumber to just camp beneath them and make landing on top of Richter very difficult.
Squid will upbeat underneath this plat once. He does it all the time. He likes the stage because upbeat reaches. And exactly.
Right there.
Yeah. He likes positioning himself mid-stage just for purely. Not for purely that, but he does like doing that after positioning himself underneath the stage. But one thing this does mess with is where you can use downbeat as Richter Belmont's from, because the slants do mess up with it, so you have to position yourself like in an odd way to just to get both whiffing off. You have to position yourself in a weird way. To get a ledge trap going.
Throwing out all of the projectiles.
Ooh.
Getting caught by the hit of one of the lingering hits. Oh, he was hoping for a roll in. But yeah, here's the thing. Now he lost the advantage. He's taking. He doesn't have. He wanted to win the roll in. Mm. I mean, not really wanted to up B early. But yeah. At this point, here's the thing. Multi hits don't work. That's just unfortunate for AOS, which would have probably confirmed the stock. And now we're just gonna see the up B's.
Yep.
Squid Plumber just doesn't matter that steals. He's building damage. Can't punish the whipped options. He looks like he buffered. Yup, too. Oh no. He lost flip kick. I don't know if he has jump. Okay, he's gonna make it back. That was great new movement. And Squid is really using that nair just to box. Just to keep AOS out. That didn't kill. That did not.
Great deal. He
can just buy.
Because the pressure is insane from all these projectiles. The up B.
Anything. The down tilt's gonna kill.
And the down tilt.
Yeah. Okay. This is the worst. He can definitely blow him up. We've seen worse situations before. At least it's not slushy game two against Big Rush.
Oh my.
But it's definitely gonna be hard because he's not able to get in. He's just struggling right now to get around Squid Plumber. He was just throwing out his projectile as well. That was, and he's not punishing on these whiffed opportunities from Squid Plumber. Like we've seen before, times when he could have killed, he's gone for like options, maybe panic options, maybe expecting something else, which would it could have been kills. He wasn't getting because he was committing to an option beforehand.
Missing these options because there's so much to keep track of. All these projectiles up, making sure that he's not getting boxed out with neutral air. There's just so many things to pay attention to with this character.
The stall and fall. It's kind of screwing him over in that attempt because Squid Plumber was able to get the up B out beforehand. And at this point, once again, he keeps staring there. We're kind of seeing a lot of these up Bs from Squid. They're working. That's the thing.
Yeah.
It's a big reason why, once again, I know he's not particularly against the stage. If they work. And, yeah. Dash attack's not gonna, he should be dead. Yeah.
Yep.
So, once again, like I said, not out of it. ZSS can just blow people up. But we saw how long that stock took. And now AOS is at 92%, so he's not even at a lower percent to deal with the stuff first. He's one good whip away from dying. We were distracted. We looked away. That was it. Oh, what did I say?
Literally look away for 2 seconds.
We looked away. Dark, why are you about to throw your controller?
Man, MTBA rowdy tonight. Good grief.
He backed the flip kicked him, apparently.
No.
He did the A. But see, that is something AOS likes to do. He likes to wait before he back throws him. That was 100% cheese. Nobody told me that wasn't cheese.
All right, we're going back to triplats with Battlefield.
Battlefield makes sense. Once again, I'm pretty sure Uppy still hits underneath. Uppy hits underneath. Or Uppy can hit the top plat. Yeah. Okay.
Right.
There we go. But it's also ZS on Battlefield. So, but I do know, once again, the platforms can actually be really good for, can be really good for Squid here. Seeing as, once again, we talked about it earlier, they're placed really well that ZSS can have a hard time getting in places.
Mm-hmm.
And makes the projectiles really good from, just makes the projectiles really good in this matchup. Mm-hmm. And allows you to. That was the longest time I've seen down B just out. They were just playing catch with it.
Hot potato.
Great on the air dodges. Oh, he committed to an option. unable to punish the last air dodge attempt. So yeah, at this point, once again, the bounce off, and that's going to be a punish for it. That should...
Whoa!
He died off that. Anyways, so we're going to, once again, we're going to have to find, see if AOS can get this kill, because if he can't get this kill soon, don't fall into the flat, he's just going to get hit by loose hitboxes, and he can't afford that. Sure. I don't know if, you know, get the grounded one death would have been better, but he was off stage and he couldn't capitalize off it. We shouldn't see a lot of this now. Yeah, do not blame. Oh, that, he should have a jump. He's fine. I think he landed, so he's, yeah.
Yeah.
But he's...
Oh, back. There we go.
Yep. Anyways, definitely, once again, not undoable. We've seen worse positions just to sit alone. And it looks like AOS is finally catching on to a lot of this projectile play and how to get around it. But at the same time, he's just falling into an axe, into a cross, and everything. He's dead.
Oh, my.
His tactical plats can't save you there.
Yeah. Just using a lot of metal options.
Remember, we saw this specifically last set, too. Not last set, last game. It's not undoable. But either Squid Plum is going to have to make some of the worst mistakes he's played, or AOS is going to have to play out of his mind. Because it seems like AOS, I'm not AOS, Squid has learned from what happened last set, not last game, and is... That, I do like those conversions he gets off of falling off air, so especially the weights. But yeah, he can't. That's a kill.
Oh. Wow.
Yep. So AOS is playing out of his mind. It's definitely. I don't necessarily think Squid messed up that much. He was just getting, you know, frame trapped at times. But here's the thing now. AOS has to play around multiple projectiles.
He's got the holy water.
And yeah, if you drop it into it, you can still get hit by it. But. He has to. He's not dead, but he air dodged.
He's dancing with death here.
Yep. Should be fine, but now he's off stage and. He's dead!
Oh, no! And that's the set.
Did Squid just pop off? I can't. Oh.
Squid Plumber taking a 2-1.
We don't have any top AOS. 4 in top in Winner's Side top 8.
That's wild. Alright, so. I think my time here is up. We got gonna leave you in the capable hands of the legend J-Dog. It's been a pleasure to cast with you, man.
Good to cast, man.
Good to meet you, and catch you some other time.